So we're off to a very special place called Takawa Park. It's a historic reserve and a par site, but it's also affectionately known as Jamroll Bay. We've made it down onto the beach. Welcome to Jamroll Bay in northern Taranaki. We're here to investigate a really interesting rock formation with a bit of help from Cape. So here I am in front of the Jamroll Rock, and this is a real Jamroll. If you take a look, the two of them have some similarities. The pale layers, we can imagine they're a bit like the sponge cake. They've curved around quite nicely and kept their shape. The darker material is thin in some places and thick in others, and looks like it's been easily squished and squeezed into the gaps, a bit like the jam. And understanding that these layers of rock have behaved like layers of sponge cake and jam actually helps us understand how it formed. The rocks here at Jamroll Bay are all sedimentary rocks. So these are the type of rocks that started off as soft, waterlogged layers at the bottom of the sea. So if that explains how the rocks could be bendy, the next question is, well, what rolled them up into this incredible rock formation? If we look all around us here at Jamroll Bay, the rocks show all kinds of mind-bending squiggles and folds and patterns. And this indicates to us that this whole area formed as part of a giant submarine landslide millions of years ago. Submarine landslides happen underneath the sea when layers of soft and waterlogged sediments are destabilized by some sort of trigger like an earthquake. They start slipping and sliding into the deepest parts of the ocean and can get all rucked up and squished and deformed into these sorts of amazing rock formations on their way.